Hi guys, it's me, Mr. Morse, and I want to talk to you guys today about what it is you're going to be making for your final product. You've turned in your paper and you got some feedback. If not, you'll be getting feedback very soon from either myself or Miss Arts on your template essay that you've turned in. But now we're going to turn our attention to the Google Slideshow, which is going to be a project you're going to be presenting and the presentation you're going to be giving. So let's talk about that now. So everything you need to know is going to be found right here in the Book Club Final Product Packet. So when you click on this here, this pops up. And of course, it's this thing right here. And you know this because you've already put your evidence, your text evidence that you put in your essay was in here. But you'll need this when we start talking about doing the project. So when you click on this link right here, you see it says slideshow right here, and you click on this link, this pops up. And this is the slideshow that I made for the paper from last year. But let me go back here and talk about this for a second. When you go down here, here are all of the directions you need to make the slideshow right here. Everything you need. So please take a look at it. Go through it. See what it says. But let's take a look at this, the one I made. Again, you've already heard me talk a little bit about this, but you're making a title slide right here, the author's name of the book, and of course you, project by Susan Blake, Kurt Morris, whoever you are. Pictures up here that relate to what it is you're going to be talking about. My introduction, I have the blue section, which is the kind of the background in your introduction. And then of course I have the snippet here from the introduction on beliefs, values, and of course the rules. And then I finally get into the beliefs paragraph, but I get ahead of myself. We're looking for interesting pictures, okay? You don't have to look for exact pictures that go along with it, but let me show what I mean. This is a book about Sarah, 10 years old, her little brother, Michelle. So I found a girl about 10 years old from an older picture. I just typed into Google 1940s 10-year-old girl. And I typed in here to Google 1940s 4-year-old boy. And I found these two pictures. So I put them on there. In the beliefs, she likes being around her family, little boy, girl, about 10, and her parents. Modern, of course, not 1940s, but it works because it tells the story, and it's basically interpreting through pictures what's going on in the book. For the presentation, you're going to need probably 8 or 9 or maybe even 10 note cards, because you're going to be writing down information that you're going to be telling the audience about your slideshow. Here, you'll start out by saying, well, let's start here. Sarah's Key by Tatiana de Rosnay, by me, Kurt Morris. And I picked these pictures because of the Jewish star of David, the key that comes along later, and of course, the book cover, Sarah's Key. Now in this book, it's about a 10-year-old girl right here named Sarah and her 4-year-old brother, Michelle. And I picked these two pictures because it kind of shows a 10-year-old girl and a 4-year-old boy. In your note card, please explain to us how the picture relates to this section of wording right here, but do not read this. We don't want you to read this. We want you just to walk us through and give a background and why you picked those pictures. In this book, Sarah has beliefs, and one of her beliefs is in her family, how much she loves them, and how much she wants to have just a normal life. I picked this picture because it looks like a 10-year-old girl and a little boy, and parents looks like they're having fun. On to the next slide. This is a key. This is very important because this is the key that she holds on to when she locks her little brother into a cabinet. Notice how I'm explaining. I have a note card and I'm explaining the key, but I'm being very brief. Locks her brother into a cabinet. More on that later. This is the key that she keeps close. No wonder why she values it. She follows rules in this book too, like always hide when the police come around. And later the rules are, we got to get out of this prison camp, this concentration camp, so she can get back to her brother. And again, interpretive. I picked this picture because it looks like a little girl hiding here. And of course, this is a little girl, probably about 10 years old, trying to get out of a concentration camp by doing all the right things and following the rules. And again, this would be on your note card. The presentation will go through each one of your note card, or excuse me, each one of your slides. And you're going to briefly talk about the pictures and what they have to do with what's going on. In the story, she gets back to the apartment which she locked her brother in many months ago. And there's a stench. And in the book, it says the stench was so bad, it was like getting punched in the face. The stench was so bad. And you can only imagine what that stench was. The reason why I picked these two pictures are, and I explain it. Have something written down on note cards. Be prepared to speak. The last thing you want to do is just get up there and stand there and go, I don't know what to say. So make sure you have something that you're going to follow along with and talk about, okay? Anyway, as I mentioned, you're going to go all the way through this to the very end. And then when you're done, the students are going to ask you questions. They might say, hey, earlier you had a picture of, I don't know what that was. Is this her family? What is that? I don't think you really explained it very well. Is that her dad, her mom? You're going to go, no. In this, I was talking about how she had to get back to her house, and these are the two people that would later help her. Oh, okay. Or they might say, hey, where did you find that picture? I really like it. And you go, oh, okay. So I found this on Google Images. What I did was I typed in, give a little bit of background. I'll let you take about three or four questions, not a lot. But make sure that your pictures tell the story, and we get a really good outline of the story through your pictures and your summarization of the story. We want to have a full picture of what happened in your book based on your presentation. And again, you'll need probably 8 or 10 note cards. And you'll write on both sides. You know, for each side of the note card will be one of your slides. Make sure you're well-spoken and you're loud. Take your time. This entire presentation should take no more than 5-7 minutes. A couple of questions thrown in there. Probably 7 or 8 minutes tops. And you're done. That's it. So today, tomorrow, which is Friday, and then on Monday, you should have this whole thing wrapped up, and we'll give you guys a few minutes to go through and, you know, do some presentations and talk and go through your note cards and talk about what you're going to say. Because you will be standing in front of the class, and we will be listening to you intently, and we can't wait to hear what you have to say. All right. Thanks for listening. Now get to work. Bye.